Reared by an uncle, George Walton was apprenticed to a carpenter and later studied law. After the death of his parents, George Walton was raised by an uncle. It is certain that Walton worked as an apprentice carpenter, but two completely different accounts of Walton's carpentry life exist in history. One view explains that the carpenter recognized how talented Walton was and sent him to school while giving him a portion of his wages. Hence, George Walton was given some formal education. The second account shows the carpenter refusing to allow Walton any education, but forcing him to work all day. Walton gathered wood chips and shavings to burn at night for light to read borrowed books. Regardless of how much help the carpenter provided, George Walton received a very limited education. When he was 28, Walton moved to Savannah, Georgia, where he met Henry Young, a lawyer. Young was so impressed by Walton's ambition that he offered Walton the use of his library to study law. Walton accepted, but it took him several years to master law because his educational background was so limited. Finally, in 1774, at age 33, George Walton was admitted to the bar. A year after he started practicing law, George Walton married Dorothy Chamber, who was the patriot daughter of a loyalist British father. George and Dorothy Walton had two sons. Walton was a very conservative man who placed little value on public opinion. After working very hard for his education, Walton had little patience for people who didn't take advantage of opportunities to improve themselves. Walton greatly respected people of merit and talent, and deeply cared for young students who needed help. He was more than willing to assist and gave opportunities to young, bright students, or as he said, put the young beagle upon the track in the chase. Walton, who was noted for his enthusiastic commitment to independence, served in the Congress on many committees and in the militia as a colonel. One of the first public meetings where independence was seriously considered in Georgia was the meeting held at the Liberty Pole at Tundy's Tavern in Savannah. George Walton was an organizer of the Liberty Pole meeting. While Lyman Hall was rallying revolutionaries in St. John's Parish, George Walton encouraged the growth of revolutionary opinion in Savannah. He strongly opposed the policy of Great Britain toward the colonies. Georgia was generally opposed to the idea of independence, hence provided little support to the Continental Congress. In July of 1775, George Walton was unanimously elected secretary of Georgia's Second Provincial Congress. Until that time, Georgia had refused to send delegates to the Continental Congress. Lyman Hall was in Philadelphia as an unofficial Georgian, actually representing only his home county. In 1775, the Provincial Congress sent four delegates to join Lyman Hall in the Continental Congress. At the Third Provincial Congress in 1776, George Walton was elected president of the Council of Safety, which was to enforce the trading embargo against Great Britain and punish violators. Georgia's Third Provincial Congress elected George Walton as a delegate to the Continental Congress. Soon after Walton arrived in Philadelphia, the Continental Congress moved to Baltimore because Great Britain was attacking Philadelphia. George Walton, George Clymer, and Robert Morris were appointed to stay in Philadelphia and proceed with the executive functions of the Continental Congress. In 1778, George Walton left the Continental Congress to serve for 2 years as a colonel in the Georgia militia. While riding in a battle during the siege of Savannah, George Walton was hit by a cannonball which knocked him off his horse and broke his leg. Walton was captured by the British and held for almost a year until September of 1779, when he was traded in a prisoner exchange. Following his release, Walton returned to Augusta. During the British occupation of Savannah, one group of patriots, without having an election, put a man in the governor's office. A second group supported George Walton for governor and succeeded in giving him the office. From November 1779 to January 1780, Walton served as governor of Georgia. While George Walton was governor, conflicts grew between the military and the civil departments of the state government. In 1779, a letter was sent to Congress, apparently signed by the Speaker of Georgia's legislature, requesting General Lackland McIntosh be removed to some distant field to exercise his abilities. The Speaker of the legislature claimed he had not signed the paper, and George Walton was accused of forgery. In 1783, McIntosh charged Walton with having known about the letter and not taking any action. Documentary proof was presented, and the legislature decided to censure Walton. However, the next day, Walton was appointed Chief Justice of the state. The Attorney General brought charges against Walton, but Walton, as Chief Justice, was presiding over the court in which his case would be presented. Nothing ever became of the charges, and Walton declared his innocence. Evidently, the people did not object to Walton's behavior because following his term as governor, Walton was returned to the Continental Congress, where he served until 1781. George Walton completed his term in the Continental Congress in 1781 and served the remainder of his life in Georgia politics. From 1783 to 1789, George Walton was Georgia's Chief Justice. Although he was elected as a delegate to the United States Constitutional Convention, Walton declined. However, in 1788, he was elected as a delegate to the State Constitutional Convention, which he accepted. George Walton also served as a United States Commissioner, negotiating a treaty with the Cherokee Indians and Tennessee, and as a Georgia presidential elector. George Walton was elected governor of Georgia in 1789. During his term, the state constitution was established. The capital was relocated in Augusta, and relations with the Creek Indians improved. While governor, George Walton moved his family from Savannah to Augusta and built Meadow Garden Cottage on land which was confiscated from the Loyalists. From 1790 to 1795, George Walton served as Justice of the State Superior Court. Then, in 1795, he completed a one-year unexpired term in the United States Senate. Again in 1799, George Walton became Justice of the State Superior Court, where he served until his death. Walton supported higher education, founding Richmond Academy and Franklin College, which later became the University of Georgia. Walton suffered from gout, and his death has been attributed to weakness resulting from the disease. When Walton was suffering much pain from the disease, he would escape to his library and read. It is recorded that he told his doctor, a book was the most effectual remedy. Walton died at his country estate, College Hill, in 1804.